I am Asha here. Today I'll be discussing on the simplex method. So how to solve the linear programming problems using simplex method. If you see the problem, it says that the objective function is to maximize, and it is given as 3x1 plus 2x2. Subjected to the constraints x1 plus x2 lesser than or equal to 4, x1 minus x2 lesser than or equal to 2, and x1 comma x2 greater than or equal to 0. So the first step is to convert this canonical form into a standard form. So first we have to see whether the problem is of maximize or minimization. Here the problem is of maximization. So let's look into the constraints. So convert the inequalities into equation. Here all the inequalities are lesser than or equal to. If the inequalities are lesser than or equal to, add the slack variables. So convert to a standard form. So x1 plus x2 plus s1 will be equal to 4, and x1 minus x2 plus s2 will be equal to 2. So here s1 and s2 are called slack variables. Here the inequalities are lesser than or equal to. So you are making that into equal to form or equation. So here left hand side is lesser than the right hand side. To make it equal to right hand side, we are adding these slack variables. So the problem is we have converted into an equation by adding the slack variables S1 and S2. In the objective function also, you have to add these variables. So it will be 0S1 plus 0S2 in the main objective function. So the variables are X1, X2, S1 and S2. Even though you have added S1 and S2 in the main objective function, it is not altering the equation. So that's why it is 0 into S1 plus 0 into S2. Now, write down the table. The first column will be the basic variables. Here we start the basic variable with the slack variables. Here the slack variables are S1 and S2. So write down S1 and S2. CBO is nothing but coefficient of basic objective function. So what are the coefficient of basic objective function? Here the basic variables are S1 and S2. The coefficient of basic variables here are 0 and 0 for S1 and S2. So write down 0 and 0. Next, coefficient of the objective functions. What are the coefficients? If you see here, x1. So write down x1, x2, s1 and s2. What are the coefficients? 3, 2, 0, 0. So write down at the top these coefficients of the objective function. 3, 2, 0 and 0. Next, you see the first equation. What is the coefficient of x1? It is 1. x2 is 1. s1 is 1. There is no s2 term, so it is 0. And the constant is 4. For the second equation, it is 1. Next is coefficient of x2 is minus 1. There is no S1 term, so coefficient is 0. S2 term is 1. Constant is equal to 2. Now you have to calculate the Z equation. It is the summation of the coefficient of basic objective function multiplied by the x values. It may be x1 or x2 or s1 or s2, the respective column values, minus the coefficient of that the respective column CO. So if you want to calculate for the first one, it will be 0 into 1. CBO value will be 0. So we'll calculate 0 into 1 plus 0 into 1. 0 into 1 minus the coefficient of x1 is 3. So it is 3. So the value will be equal to minus 3. So write down here minus 3. So like that calculate CBO value is 0 into 1 plus 0 into minus 1 minus 2 is minus 2. Similarly, 0 into 1 plus 0 into 0 minus 0 will be 0. Again, 0 into 0 plus 0 into 1, 0 minus 0 is 0. See, in the z value, you see the values. If all the values are positive, then this is the optimal solution. If negative values are there, you see the most negative value. Here the minus 3 is the most negative value. So this will become the key column. Okay. So this is the key column. So now once you have got the key column, so constant is 4 divided by element in the key column is 1. So ratio is 4. Again, constant is 2 divided by the element is 1, that will be equal to 2. So in this ratio, select the least positive value. Among 4 and 2, least positive value is 2. So this becomes the key row. Okay. So that means x1 will be entering the table and s2 will be leaving the table. Whichever is the horizontal, that will be leaving the table. Key column, that is x1, will be entering. So here write down, this is s1. Instead of s2, x1 is entering. So here it is x1. What is the coefficient of S1 in the objective function? It is 0. X1, it is 3. See, here you have got the key row, key column. Intersection will be called the key element. So this is the key element. Always in the next table, the key element should be 1. Here already it is 1, so write the same row. So it is 1, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. Okay. Apart from the key element, whichever other elements are present in that column, that should be 0. So you have to make this S1 value as 0. In order to make that, you add the for R3, it is R3 will be equal to R4 is nothing but R2 only. So you have R4 is R2 only. R3 will be equal to R1 minus R2. R1 minus R2. Then this value will become 0. So what is R1 value? 1. minus R2 value is 0. Again here R1 value is 1, minus of minus 1 is 2. 1 minus 0, 1. 0 minus 1 is minus 1. Again, 4 minus 2 is 2. Now, get the z equation, that is CBO into x1, 0 into 0, 0, plus 3 into 1 is 3, minus 3 is 0. Again, 0 into 2 is 0, plus 3 into minus 1 is minus 3, minus 2 is minus 5. Again, 0 into 1 is 0, plus 3 into 0 is 0, minus 0 is 0. 0 into minus 1 is 0, plus 3 into 1 is 3. 3 minus 0 is 3. Now, in this, the most negative value is minus 5. So, this becomes the key column. Okay. So, get the ratio 2 by 2 is 1. 2 by minus 1 equal to minus 2. So in this 1 and minus 2, the least positive value is 1. So this is the key row. That means S1 will be leaving the table. Instead of S1, X2 will be entering the table. So here, X2 and X1. So the coefficient of X2 is 2 in the objective function, 3 is X1. Now the key element, so this will become the key element, intersection of the key row and the key column is the key element. So this key element have to be unit element, that is 1. So in order to make this R5 row here, it has 1. So you will be doing R5 will be equal to R3 by 2. So it is R5, that is fifth row, will be equal to R3 divided by 2. Okay. So 0 by 2 is 0. 2 by 2 is 1. 1 by 2 is half. Minus 1 by 2 is minus half. 2 by 2 is 1. The next element, next to that key element, should be 0. So you have to, in R6, this value has to become 0. So how do you make that? So R6, that is the sixth row, will be equal to R3 by 2 plus R4. Okay. So here, if you take 0 by 2 is 0 plus R4 is 1. Again here, 2 by 2 is 1 minus 1 is 0. 1 divided by 2 is half plus 0 is half. Again here, minus 1 by 2 plus 1 is half. Again, 2 by 2 is 1. 1 plus 2 is 3. Now, calculate the z value. Okay, 2 into 0 is 0 plus 3 into 1 is 3 minus 3 is 0. Again, 2 into 1 is 2 plus 3 into 0 is 0. 2 minus 2 is 0. 2 into half is 1 plus 3 by 2 is 5 by 2. Again, 2 into minus half is minus 1 plus 3 by 2 is half. So it is 5 by 2 and half. Okay. So all the values in the z equations are 0 and positive. So this is the optimal solution. Now we have x1 value. You see the x1 value is 3. And x2 value is 1. So substitute x1 and x2 in the z equation. We have z equals 3 into 3 plus 2 into 1. So 9 plus 2 is 11. So this is the final solution for the given problem. Okay, z value is 11.